We're gonna make it cooler. We're gonna cool it. This is the volume.
So we have four things to make, the four intake, the shooter, something to move from the intake to the shooter, and then something to climb onto that like second block.
Right now we're planning intake. There's a lot to consider. So I guess starting with the intake, obviously we need to be able to get the balls to shoot them. We thought about doing horizontal wheels, so these would extend beyond the frame perimeter, and then the wheels would spin inwards and then hit the balls in that way. The issue is if the wheels spin too fast, it'll kick the balls away, and if we have the intake wheels move too slow, you'll wind up pushing the balls out of the way.
We thought about having vertical wheels on like two rods that you could just kind of place on top of the ball and suck the ball inward. But that might be a little difficult just trying to keep it inside the frame perimeter. And then also, if we were going to use that same mechanism to shoot, calculating that angle.
We're working on brainstorming intake. So we got a couple different things. We got sort of the over the ball intake that a lot of people do, where just the wheel spins and it sweeps the ball in. The other option that we're considering is the like kind of two wheels parallel or next to each other, and then the ball kind of goes in like that.
Well, we don't need a lot, unlike our previous robot, where we are actually storing the ball, we have a lot of space for it.
Right.
We have not storage space. We only need very small storage space.
That's true.
In that case, I think this might be a bit too wasteful.
If you're going to have a really short robot, but not really tall, you could have this be kind of like have a storage space for a box, or for like one or two balls.
And yes, if we could figure out some sort of,
you mean like one of these? Like I remember doing this.
I love this.
Yeah.
Yeah, so what I like about like these kinds is the rollers are like, you can make them horizontal so you don't have to worry about lining up exactly. You can just do a little, and then my idea was to avoid actually having to target and then shoot a long distance, have it like drive up and grab the ball and then back up against the thing, tilt back like this. Yeah, and then shoot up and backwards. And just have it be a hard, goes back, goes forwards. I don't think.
Oh, gosh, so have it like programmed to have a hard stop right where it needs to be.
No, don't even program it. Have a hard stop. Have a hard stop. It would flip over.
Whatever.
Deep space
with the balls.
Yep. That was the type of intake that we
did. Yeah, where we did something similar with balls or whatever, and it was just kind of difficult to try to grab them because sometimes it would fling through. Like if you just have two rows of wheels, right? You try to grab it and it flings all the way through.
Something in the back to catch it?
Yeah. Well, and that's what we did for our intake that year. But I remember it was more difficult than you expect.
So climbing, it seems pretty straightforward, especially because we don't care about the last two rungs. We've established that working towards those two rungs is too much work, and we will not be able to adequately build a system to do that in the time we have here. So we're thinking that we can probably get away with just either an arm or something that telescopes, like an elevator or maybe a telescoping arm, something really simple, really, really few moving parts ideally, just puts a hook on that rug and then we just winch ourselves up.
We're done with the climber now. So we've got two possible concepts so far. We've got sort of this like two-prong thing, if you have like some sort of elevator system that lifts up, or kind of similar to what we did previously. On the top side and attaches the hook and then the hook actually pulls up. We're liking this one a lot because it's pretty simple and we've done it before.
We're coming back together after our brainstorming session. We're talking about how we feel in our hearts.
And also how we're going to build a robot.
Mostly that.
I kind of want to talk about my feelings.
No. I have a few things drawn over here. Most of it's unintelligible. My apologies. I'm not great at art. So we have a couple things. We were thinking about the fact that this bottom scoring zone is 3 feet, 5 inches off the ground. We're like, okay, that's noticeably smaller, or sorry, shorter than the actual vacuum height for your robot. We did the math there, so you'll have about an inch and a half of clearance on top of the ball if you just wanted to literally roll something off the top of your robot into that scoring zone. And so, like, let's assume your robot's a triangle and a ball runs up it for some reason and then falls into the scoring. That's 1 point. Fantastic. Good job, team. Then we're going to think about how this is 8.5 feet in the air, which is really, really tall. I actually can't remember the last time anything's been that tall in a game. It's kind of crazy.
One of the things we considered with the intake was, because we talked about, like, when we started this discussion, we wanted to work on four things, one of those being how do we want to get balls from the intake to the shooter. One of the things we played around with a lot was what if we just didn't deal with that, so we, lots of our ideas tried to minimize intake to shooters. So.
Essentially, you have a square box with two rows of wheels on it, and you're able to go out and just kind of squish it on a ball, and then the ball is inside the box, right? So you have rollers here, ball is here. That way you don't have to traverse the ball through the robot, you know, because that was one of our issues in RA3D 2 years ago, in that getting the ball from the intake to the shooter was kind of difficult. We could potentially do somewhat where it's we don't have to traverse it much, where literally the flywheel or whatever is right on the bottom of the robot, so we're not actually taking the ball and like moving it like up an elevator to then shoot it. All we need to do is potentially just keep the ball here and then shoot it from the bottom of the robot, basically.
If there was a way to keep the shooter mechanism low, like down to the ground, that would eliminate the need to really take the ball once it's in the robot and put it somewhere else that's also in the robot. And if you get a powerful or a fast enough flywheel, it might not be very difficult to get the ball up high. It would just be aiming then is the issue.
And it's not completely clear what the benefits for the two balls are when you weigh it against.
I mean, it's just cycle time, right?
Sure.
Well, exactly. If you have a very fast robot that is very good at picking up balls, it might not matter if you can store two or not, if your cycle time between intaking the ball and shooting the ball is fast enough.
We'll start with the intake. Okay, we landed upon this like the same kind of idea that we had
2 years ago.
Previously. Yes, 2 years ago. And make it so that it's basically a little lighter than one ball. That way you don't end up with the problem of having like two balls that get jammed. For a shooter, we thought instead of doing just the one wheel with the hood like we did last time, we do something with two wheels, so top and bottom. That way you can tune the wheels different speeds to like change the angle of it. And also not this fairly vertically, because if you look at the goal, it's like this is kind of where the robot can sit. You can just shoot straight up into here with our kind of thoughts. So that way you don't really even have to aim. You just run into the wall of the blow thing, shoot, and then go. That could increase your cycle time while also being a reliable way of not like having to aim every time. Going from the intake to the shooter, we sort of landed upon a similar thing to what we did last time, guys. This little sketch down here, we could either do a belt or just a bunch of wheels. And instead of doing it on the top, we do it on the bottom. That way the ball should like land on the wheels basically as they kind of go up. Because contrary to 2 years ago, it's not a very grippy ball on the outside, it's sort of like a tennis ball material. So having something that relies mostly on friction would probably not be the best design, which is kind of our thought. So when it's something that's towards the ball, it's sort of resting on whatever you bring it up.
All right, so we'll start with the climber. Pretty simple, just an elevator system where you just get two rails that are able to slide, in each other, and you're able to run a carrot cord or something to be able to just elevate, a single rail. After that, we would need something to actually be able to grab onto the rail. We could do a hook. We were also thinking about potentially putting a carabiner sideways, or we could do some enabling system. Yes, you could.
It's like more of a square carabiner. It's able to be placed directly beneath the bar, which is that circle. And when it's driven up, the bar is allowed to pass through the two wings. And once the bar is through and those wings snap back to their original position, you're allowed to like lift up on it because the bar will not be able to get out of those wings because they can't bend the other way.
So you would have a paracord or something attached to this attached to a severance. So this would take two full motors, unfortunately, unless we could figure out like a clutch system or whatever for the event. Probably not. So two flow motors, and then, you know, just driven separately.
Just trying to figure out the best place to attach the winch to the robot so that when we lift up, we're not damaging anything while we're tipping and just kind of free floating in the air. If we can't find like the very center part of the robot to attach the winch to, we could potentially have two hooks so that we have two points of contact on the like on the bar, and we wouldn't be swaying and tipping around.
Anyway, two separate elevators to be able to center the mass to make light, you know, so it's not tipping and moving around as much. Potentially, depends on how we decide.
So let the climber basically just do it the last time. Just lift up a hook, put some rope on it, and then climb up using the hook. I don't think there's any like set height you have to get to. I'm pretty sure you just have to get off the ground. Correct me if I'm wrong, of course.
I didn't see anything.
How's that? I think it's just get off the ground.
Sure. Yeah.
Okay,
so,
don't
get
alright, so we seem to kind of agree upon the climber for the most part. I'm just sort of like having something and then using like a winch to pull us all down.
We already have the winch.
We already have the winch.
Someone cut the rope. And then the only real decision that we have to make there is if we want to go arm or an elevator. And I,
considering we've done arm in the past, but I don't know. I mean,
yeah.
To make an elevator, you need some sort of like racket pinion or like a telescoping.
When you say arm, you mean something that just lays flat, and just go up.
That was my thought.
Do we have the torsure to be able to do that? Is the question. I know we have 120 and a quarter.
I mean, do we know how big?
The robot can be 4.4 max.
Yeah, 4.4 max.
Yeah,
it's only over 13 or 14 inches.
So we could definitely do an arm.
Sure. Other thing to think about the arm deal is that if we have two other teams which are able to do the medium run and only the medium run, we would not be able to do the smaller run.
I don't think that's true.
Is there?
I don't think that's true.
Yeah, no, I guess, you can just angle it like.
I'll say, I don't think
that's
true.
Right? Yeah, you can reach the hook because the small
rotating doesn't matter.
Yeah, as long as the hook has enough overhang or whatever, has enough hook on the hook, I think you're on. Yeah.
I do kind of want to do the carabiner just so that we're not.
I'm down to prototype it.
To be fair, it's a carabiner. It's not like it's going to be very difficult for us to do. We could just do like a not an elevator system. We could also potentially not cut out a hole and maybe just, I don't know, do a row of wheels or whatever that grabs the ball and lifts them up over the ball. Of course, we don't have pneumatics to be able to push that arm out because it has to start inside.
No, you'd be fine. You literally just let it fall over. I like over the bumper personally. I think that it'd be really cool for us to close off our bumper, have it be a nice closed rectangle, and then we intake over the bumper. And I know that you had specifically talked about having it just wide enough to have a ball and a little bit of leeway, but not two. I don't know if that's... I'm not convinced that having two at the same time would really be that much of a problem, especially depending on the way that we, like, come at it. If we had a wider intake, it gives us more surface area for us to, like, hit and have a good spot on the ball.
Essentially, we have the box O robot here. We have arm intake or whatever that kind of juts out here, and then we have, like, you know, the wheels on here. Right, and then thank you. And then we have some sort of tray or whatever where the balls can hang out here, and then from there we have our shooter back here, which is we could just do literally just like the flywheel designer that kind of looks like a turbo basically, in which we just fling them up. Actually, it'd be this way. We could do our arms or whatever we wanted, arm or arms, depending on like here, or we could potentially even do it like sideways. You know, we would have a lot of options, but it. You know, that would be very low to the ground. So.
We could. Oh god, there's no way we have a rotating turret. That's actually
I don't think there's
completely remove what
we have to
Tuesday.
I like having the tray idea, and especially if we had it tapered, so that we could collect, mm-hmm. two balls in there, but then it would feed in one at a time. I like that.
On the topic of defense, it is interesting to note you are allowed to pick up your opponent's game pieces. You are allowed to.
But you weren't.
You are. You're not allowed to hold on to more than like three of them at a time. So if you had a robot that for some reason can hold balls and can pick them up but can't score them, you can have them go pick up two of your opponent's balls and then just play regular defense, running around, having a good old time, bashing into them.
That's pretty funny.
So this would also give us the opportunity to not, like, when we are lifted or whatever, by not having a super tall robot, we don't have to worry about banging into anyone else. That's also, like, having it small and compact, I think, is better in the end. It just makes our lives easier and it makes things simpler. Also, like I said, when you're up and it's wiggling around because we only have a single winch on a single part of our chassis or whatever, I think it would be beneficial to not have something that's really, like, hanging out.
Were there any rules regarding once you are hanging, you can't have anything outside your perimeter?
I think the same 16 inch.
That's something really important to consider for using a rope. If the robot turns horizontally,
plane parallel to your bumper.
Oh, is it?
Yeah. So even if your robot tilts, you're still good.
Are we doing one winch? Or are we going to do
two? It would probably be one.
One makes more sense to me, and it really shouldn't be a problem, especially if we don't have a rotating turret. We can put it wherever we want, as long as it isn't directly in our shooting path.
No, but if you had four ropes that were tied into one, the other thing is that if we just winch it, it
pulls both of these at the same time.
Yeah, that's fine. I'm okay with that.
The other thing to think about is that technically, if we're like this, when we're going up, if we are able to winch, and so the bar is here, and we're able to wrench like really close to our thing, it's not going to be as big of an issue because, like, if we're down here, it's an issue technically because, you know, it's extending past that planar boundary. But if we're here, we're right next to the bar, we're able to get that winch really close.
You don't even need to put the winch motor up there. You could have the winch motor down low and just have like a good guide at the top.
That is also true. Yeah.
You have two motors, but you're saying four ropes. So.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
But I'm saying, do we need two sets, or can you just do two?
If you just do two, there's still one. I'm just saying four,
because having one in each corner, like having a rope extending up from each corner, is more stable. If that's what we're really
doing, actually need four. We can also just get like three. Three might be harder than four.
Yeah, three is harder than four.
Yeah, you're right.
With how balanced this robot is looking, do we need to worry about this in detail right now, or should
not even a little bit. I mean, are we shooting? Do we care if we shoot out the front or the back? I think shooting out the front makes more sense because it's just a little bit more leeway. But we're probably just going to mortar pretty much straight up, right?
Right. Well, the one thing that we could, if we want to shoot towards the back, right? Yeah. Because you can just back into, like, the
defense area. Worst comes to worst, we can just underpower the motor and just get that bottom one. Like, we don't necessarily have to absolutely go for the top if we can't, for some reason, figure it out.
That's twice as many wheels.
are you thinking two wheels, like, this way or like this? Okay, gotcha.
Well, I think you could get both heights with a flywheel motor, just depending on how fast you want
it. Yeah, sure. The only issue.
But if we can get both, would we ever even want to hit the bottom one?
Yeah.
No.
So, for the arm bar, wheel bar thing.
Intake.
I guess that is the intake. Yeah, okay. You can just do a simple belt drive. I don't know what kind of, for the axle or whatever, I don't know what material we have, but like a hexagon shaft or something like that would be perfect.
We might,
and then we'll have to experiment with sizes and everything to actually get the ball to roll up. And this is also assuming that the texture of the ball will allow us to actually pick up the ball and roll it over the bumper, because that is one thing that I'm thinking about right now. If the ball is like tennis ball texture or whatever, getting that ball to actually be sticky enough to get up over the bumpers might be a bit of an issue.
Compliance. Are we all vaguely in agreement that we like this idea as opposed to the other idea of rebuilding the same robot we had 2 years ago?
I think so.
I like this.
In favor.
Okay. That's so right now we're breaking apart into more groups after we have a big old strategy meeting. So we're just going to break into four groups to start prototyping and see how some things work in practice.
Hope it works.
And so far, we have down the wonderful time. I'm not doing that. It would be my problem.
You're right.
And I'm not doing it.
Okay. Are we just going to keep saying numbers? Because I'll say five. Where
are you even going to put a fifth wheel? It doesn't make any sense. No.
Yeah,
we'll talk at the same time. That way, we don't have to spend as much time on this. We can save more time at the end for parking.